driver for the implementation of post-2015 Sustainable Development Goals. My name's Marty Ullner. I'm the mayor of the Village of Lawrence. I'm the chairman of Religious Zionists of America. And I thank Shoshana and Ms. Flores, Ambassador Flores, for having us here today. It is really an honor to be here and introduce our panel. The subject that we're going to be talking about are the Noahide laws and the post-2015 agenda. And leading that charge certainly is Rabbi Yaakov David Cohn, founder and director of the Institute of Noahide Code. He comes from an education at Lubavitch. He's been educated in, has his degree from Lubavitch and an additional degree in Australia. But most importantly, I think what we need to pause upon is the great work of the Lubavitch Rebbe himself in having the foresight of being the first in the early 80s to introduce this program of Noahide mitzvot, the Sheva mitzvot shel b'nei Noach. He was an unusual person, an unusual being. He was a person of unlimited resources and foresight. And one of his major focuses on a Saturday, Parshas Bashalach, in 1986, was to purposely focus on this important need for how it would change the world. He was focused on the fact that this was something that had to be revived. It had to be looked at for many years. And what he was able to do was convince Congress, who had earlier in the Reagan administration understood the importance of the Sheva Mitzvot Shel B'nei Noach, to, on something called Education Day, to go forward with this very important project. And rather than introduce the other speakers at this time, I'd like to call upon Rabbi Cohn.
Thank you. Welcome to today's summit. Today, we will be discussing the idea of the Universal Noahide Code in mobilizing cultural and religious ethics for the Agenda 2015. First, I want to thank our sponsors, Her Excellency Mr. Roland Kroh from the Permanent Mission of Panama. I want to thank Mrs. Shoshana Beckerman. I also want to thank all ambassadors, delegates, and distinguished guests, and UN staffers who have taken the time out of their busy schedule to join us in this important program. I would like to open with a statement from Rabbi Shimon ben Gamliel, who says, "The world rests on three pillars: justice, truth, and peace." Our sages explain that the three are one in the same. For if there is justice, there is truth. If there is truth, there is peace. People don't look alike, don't think alike, but we're all created in the divine image. We need to find the common thread that unites us all. Today, November 9th marks the 77th anniversary of Kristallnacht, a night of darkness in which we are here, and today we are here to bring light and peace to all people with the Universal Noahide Code of Noah. Seven laws for 70 nations in the United Nations, which is 770. The Torah has a metaphor for light, for goodness, and darkness, evil. Unity is based on identification, namely, when we see one, not two, as Aristotle said, and confirmed in Jewish mysticism. Love is one soul in many bodies. When we realize we are intrinsically one, our outer appearances don't differentiate. At the same time, we must be proactive. For the forces of hate, like pre-war Europe, are fanning into the minds and hearts of educating hundreds of millions that murder is holy, rape is sacred. Wherever there is darkness, we must bear in mind in the saying of Hillel, "Though, if I am not for myself, who will be? Nonetheless, I'm not only for myself, what does that make me?" As the President of Panama stated in the United Nations this year, "I preside over a government that based its foreign policy on dialogue and consensus in a permanent search of social peace and common good." We call on all great powers to do the same as they came together 70 years ago to end the Second World War. We work together the roadmap to defeat terrorism and allow lasting peace to reach all nations. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. For us to come together, we need to be one. For us to have unity, we need to be one. For God to have unity, He needs us as individuals to come together. There have been many ideas of how to unite humanity, most of which have caused much violence, such as communism. The only idea practically is, as mentioned, when we identify the common thread, the one thing we all have in common is we're all God's people. We're all created by God. In fact, in this sense, we not only have in common with our fellow humans, we have in common with animals and even the environment. We need a vigorous campaign, a proactive campaign, which I'm proud that my organization, the Institute of Noahide Code, stands for, which all people are elevated to the understanding that their lives are a choice. God chose them, for He loves them, to bring light and love and unity and harmony. When we realize we are His ambassadors of goodness, and we do good, this gives us an inner sense of worth. We respect ourselves and love ourselves, and extends to our fellow. There's a great Talmudic story I heard here in the United Nations that I'd like to share. For many years, there were disputes between the two famous schools of thought, between the school of Shammai and Hillel, escalated. Hillel's school usually won the outcome in terms of Jewish law, but the disciple of Shammai decided to test the disciple, Rabbi Hillel. So he took a butterfly in his hand, and he asked Rabbi Hillel the question, the butterfly I have in my hand, is it alive or dead? And the disciple figured out that he would say it was alive, he would simply crush his hand and show him it was dead. And if he would say it was dead, he would open his hand and let it fly away. Confident that he'd win this argument, he went and knocked on the door of Rabbi Hillel. He said, Rabbi Hillel, the butterfly I have in my hand, is it alive or dead? Rabbi Hillel smiled and said, the answer is in your hand. Member of this forum, the Jewish people, the Holy Land of Israel, are not just here to stay, but to flourish in helping others improve their living standards, as we've done so during the catastrophes of Haiti, Africa, Nepal, Indonesia, and so on, and assist others' needs, regardless of race, religion. We continue to do so in times of war, in times of peace, in times of growth, in times of disaster. One who saves one person saves the entire world. The Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Joseph Isaac Schneerson, and the previous Lubavitcher Rebbe, spoke about a great hurricane, a great flood happening before the coming of the Messiah. And the coming Messiah is a time when the world will realize its fruition and the shroud of darkness will disappear. And it's interesting that a few years ago, meteorologists have been battered by the Hurricane Katrina, which recently landed in North America. And the Rebbe explained that this catastrophe is to show leaders that really they have to look out for the one and all, for Hashem, for God, and have to realize there's an eye that sees, there's an ear that hears, and so on. And only then will the citizens of the world have peace, truth, and justice. However, in the chaos theory, it teaches, the smallest revolution, the simplest idea, extra idea of goodness and kindness, will have a ripple-like effect. So in conclusion, I humbly request that we all think one more practical addition in the realm of goodness and kindness, right here, in this room, individually, hence collectively, we'll undertake. I give you a moment to think about this. It is this positive energy that will have a ripple-like effect in cosmic wave in the hearts and minds and feelings and consciousness individuals and collective through ushering in a positive world. Today, we carry the responsibility of being a beacon of mutual understanding, mutual respect, bettering this world. We have to defeat ignorance, fear, prejudice, so we can prevent violence. We have to start right at our kitchen tables with our families, in our homes, in our schools, with social media,
and our wings should spread globally. A bit of light dispels much darkness. We need not worry about the numbers, for darkness is the absence of light. A butterfly flaps its wings in Israel and creates a storm of bitterness in Africa. Thank you.